Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to start our video class on EVS. Our today's topic is family and surrounding. Before starting the lesson, hope children you have understood what you have explained in the previous class. What we have studied, living things and non-living things. What are living things? Living things, things which can breathe, which can move, which can reproduce, which can eat, those are living things. And things which cannot move, things which cannot eat, things which cannot breathe are non-living things. Beside that, I also taught you natural and man-made things. What are natural things? Things which are given to us by God. Those are natural things. Example, we human beings, we are natural. Plants are natural. Animals are natural. Rivers, rocks, hills, mountains, these are all natural. And the things which are made by man are man-made things. Example, table, bench, book, these are man-made things, things made by man. So the man-made things, all the things which are made by man are non-living things. So that was the topic which we have studied in the previous lesson. Today we are going to start family and surrounding. What is a family? Now children, presently you are at home. Who is at your home? What is the answer you will be given? You will be telling me my father, my mother, my brother, my sister. So who are these? This is your family. These all members together makes a family. Some children says that, what they say? Beside your father, mother, brother, who is their sister? Some are having their uncle, aunt. Some are having grandmother, grandfather. So some are having a small family. Some will have a joint family or a big family. So the members who are staying in your family, they together makes a, those the members which are living in your family, they are your family members. So some families are big, some families are small. In some families they are only 3 members, 4 members. In some families they are 5 members, 8 members, 10 members. Like that, all the families will not have same members. Now you are sitting and listening to my class. Okay? Now what are the things around you? So different children will be giving me different answers. Some says my mother is beside me, there is a television or an almara or a fridge or a toys or book. There are many things surrounding you. There are many things around you. So what the things which are around you may be living things and non-living things. The things which are around you are living things and non-living things. Did you understood? So the things which are around you, we call them as surrounding. What we call? Surrounding. Surrounding is nothing but the things which are around you. These are your surroundings. So I already explained you what is a family. The members in your family together, they makes a family. So this is your family. A family can be a bigger, small. And then the things which are around you is your surrounding. Now you are at home. What are the things you see around you is your surrounding. Just come out of your house. Think that you are on the road. When you are on the road, what are the things you see? You see different kinds of vehicles. We can see plants. We can see some animals like cat and dog when you are on the road. So these are your surroundings when you are on the road. When you are walking on the road, these are your things which you can see. That means that is your surrounding. The vehicle, the trees, the what you can say, animals which is around you, that is your surroundings. Suppose you are sitting in a classroom. I will be asking you what is around you. What are the things around you? What you will be what is the answer you will be giving me? Your first, your classmates. Who is in your class? Your classmates. Benches, books, your stationery items, pencil, your rubber, eraser, whatever it is. These are the things which is around you in your class, when you are in your classroom. So the surroundings, the things which are around you, those are the surroundings. And they can be living things and non-living things. You are telling your classmates. You are not alone in the class. You are with your classmates. So your classmates are living things. Now you are having bench, books, pencil, these all. These are non-living things. So the things which are around you may be living things and non-living things. So the things which are around you is your surrounding. What is your surrounding? The things which are around You is your surrounding. This is the family, this is the surroundings. And now coming to, suppose you are in the house and you are playing with your toys. What you are going to do? You are playing with your toys. For some time you have played, then you leave it off and go away. If your mother calls or if you have some other work. Is that the correct way? No, that is a wrong way. What you have to do? After playing with the toys, you have to keep them in the proper place. What we have to do? We have to keep them in the proper place. Now suppose you are doing your school homework, you are playing with the books or writing or reading, whatever you are doing. So you will be taking or drawing. You will be taking out all your crayons, your pencil, your books, and you will be doing your work. As soon as you finish your work, you will throw it away and go. That is the wrong habit. What you have to do? You have to keep the things in the proper way. So when you keep all the things in the proper way in your room, how the room looks? It looks very neat and tidy. So when you are doing any work, after completing, either you are playing or writing, try to keep those things in their proper place. Arrange them in their proper place so that the work, whatever, in whichever room you are, it looks very neat and clean and tidy. So one thing what you are going to learn here, you have to keep your surroundings clean. You have to keep your house clean, your room clean, your surroundings which are around you. And not only that, when you are on the road, when you are in the school, not that you are taking a paper out of your books, you are sharpening and throwing it here and there, you are littering the things. That is a very bad habit. Suppose when you are in the school, what you have to do? There is a dustbin, go near the dustbin, sharp your pencil, but don't litter the things here and there. Suppose if you are eating something on the road, don't throw it away. See where is the dustbin and throw it in the dustbin. Littering the things here and there, that is throwing the things here and there, is a very bad habit. Try to keep your surroundings clean. Try to keep your house clean. Try to keep your classroom neat and clean. Now in order to green surroundings, come to green surroundings. How the surroundings will become green? You have to color it with the green color? No. In order to keep the surroundings green means you have to plant trees. What you have to do? You have to plant more trees. So what happened with the trees? Trees give you fresh air. What they'll give you? Fresh air. And what we are breathing? We are breathing oxygen. The oxygen which we are breathing comes from the trees, from the plants. So it is better if we plant, it is good if we plant more and more trees. It gives us shade, it gives us fruits, it gives us cool breeze, it gives us oxygen. There are many useful things which we get from the plants. So try to keep our surroundings clean, plant more trees, water them, take care of the plants. It is a very good habit. So in this lesson, we have studied family. What is the family we have studied? Surroundings. How you should keep your surroundings? Whether you are in your room, try to keep your things properly. In your house, or if you are out of your house, if you are in the class, everywhere, wherever you are, try to maintain cleanliness. Try to maintain cleanliness. Try to be neat and tidy. Keep yourself neat and tidy, your surroundings neat and tidy. So in order to keep our surroundings green, we have to plant more trees. So that trees, we are having many benefits from the trees, many advantages from the trees. Trees gives us oxygen which we are breathing, which is very essential for us. So beside that, it gives us cool breeze, it gives us fresh air, it gives us shade, it gives us fruits and so on. So one thing remember children, try to keep your surroundings neat and clean, try to plant more and more trees. Hope you have understood the lesson, that is family and surroundings. Thank you.